Good day, grade 12s. My name is Viola from the Distinction Bound Student, and I'd like to welcome you to exam tips for business studies. I'll start with the most basic tip and probably the most important. Choose your preferred topics for each paper the first day you start preparing for business studies exams. On day 1, take your time to choose the topics that you are going to spend most of your time studying, which then becomes the one you answer in the exam. I think deciding during the exam will be too late because there is nothing you can do to prepare because you are already in the exam. I hope my message is clear. If you are a level 1 student, meaning you always get between 0 and 29%, my advice is that you only need to master one module for each of our papers, and I'll show you my recommendation shortly. If you are a level 7, you need to master both modules, but still, I advise you to choose your most preferred module. That way you can spend slightly more time on the module. Let's get going. We will start off by having a look at our topics. For paper 1, we have business environments and business operations, and for paper 2, we have business ventures and business roles. Between the two from each paper, which one do you understand more? Let us assume you prefer business environments for paper 1 and business ventures for paper 2. In that case, your preferred questions in the exam will be as follows. Question 1, because it's compulsory. In section B, the instruction says answer any two of the three questions in this section, and that will be questions 2, 3, and 4. Because of your preferred module, you then answer question 2 because all 40 marks are questions from business environments in paper 1 and business ventures in paper 2. Skip question 3 because you did not fully prepare for business operations in paper 1 and business roles in paper 2. Answer question 4 because 20 marks, which is half of the full 40 marks, is from business environments in paper 1 and business ventures in paper 2. Lastly, in section C, the instruction says you should answer only one of the two essay questions, so in that case you answer question 5 because all 40 marks comes from business environments in paper 1 and business ventures in paper 2. This advice applies for all learners. The only difference is that learners who target levels 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, which is from 40 to 100%, should study everything in the syllabus, but I still strongly recommend that you spend more time on your preferred module. Level 1 students who just want to pass and get between 30 and 39% should spend 100% of your study time doing that one module that you chose. If your target is 40 to 49%, spend 90% of your study time on your preferred module and the other 10% on your less preferred module. That way you increase your chance of getting a higher mark in questions 1 and 4 since those questions will also include your less preferred module. If your target is 50 to 59%, spend 80% of your study time on your preferred module and 20% on your less preferred module. If your target is 60 to 69%, spend 70% of your study time on your preferred module and 30% on your less preferred module. If your target is 70 to 100%, spend 60% of your study time on your preferred module and 40% on your less preferred module. If you are unique, however, and you prefer to choose questions in the exam based on how difficult or easy the question is, then rather spend 50% on each of the two modules. Remember, don't be a follower, be a student. Listen to what I say and listen to what other teachers are saying, then make up your own mind and do that which you see would give you a higher mark. So for paper 1, which module do I recommend? I can't really say which one is easier, but based on this bar graph, it's clear that learners in November 2022 performed better in business operations than business environments for both sections B and C. So you can use this information to make up your mind. For paper 2, we can also see that learners performed better in business ventures than they did in business roles. This shouldn't be the only thing you should consider when deciding on which module to spend much of your time studying. Also consider your personal strength to make your decision. Another factor to consider is that maybe for 2022 the paper was more challenging on those particular modules that learners struggled in. So in conclusion, go for the topic you understand the most. So let us have a quick look at the topics. Module 1 is business environments, and it has three topics, namely legislation, business strategies, and business sectors. Module 2 is business operations, which only has two topics, namely human resource function and quality of performance. Based on the workload, business operations has less content to study, and I believe it would be a better choice for many. Some learners, however, would prefer business environments. Choose carefully and decide ahead of time. For paper 2, our first module is business ventures, which has five topics, namely management and leadership, investment, securities, investment, insurance, forms of ownership, and lastly presentation and data response. The second module in Paper 2 is Business Roles, which also has five topics, namely Ethics and Professionalism, Creative Thinking and Problem Solving, CSR and CSI, Human Rights, Inclusivity and Environmental Issues. Finally, we have Team Performance Assessment and Conflict Management. For Paper 1, I prefer Business Operations because it has less content and I believe it would be a perfect fit for our Level 1 learners. For Paper 2, I prefer Business Ventures. What do you prefer for each paper and why? Let us know in the comments section down below. Now that you have chosen your preferred topic, let us discuss other tips. Make sure your responses are in full sentences for sections B and C. However, this would depend on the nature of the question. Next tip is on your ability to decide on how much you should go with each of your responses in the entire question paper. For instance, advise, name, state, outline, motivate, recommend, suggest, and list do not usually require much depth in candidates' responses. Therefore, the mark allocation for each statement or answer appears at the end. Define, describe, explain, discuss, elaborate, distinguish, differentiate, compare, tabulate, analyze, evaluate, and critically evaluate require a greater depth of understanding, application, and reasoning. Therefore, the marks must be allocated more objectively to ensure that assessing is conducted according to established norms so that uniformity, consistency, and fairness are achieved. Next tip, if the question requires 6 facts, don't waste your time giving 8 because they will mark the first 6 and ignore the extra 2 facts that you gave. For example, name any 3 examples of fringe benefits. If you give 6 examples and the first 3 are wrong and the last 3 are correct, you will be awarded 0 marks because they will mark the first 3. So you will have wasted your time on this question by listing 6 instead of 3. Remember, time in an exam is of huge importance. Don't spend time on points or facts that won't even be considered and end up not having the time to answer what would have been marked correct. This applies only to questions where the number of facts is specified. It also applies to responses in Section C where applicable. When it comes to essays, you can earn 8 marks for the following 4 points. Number 1, the structure of your response is extremely important. Your essay should have an introduction, body, and conclusion. You get 2 marks just for ensuring that your essay has the correct structure. It has ever been this easy to get 2 marks. Number 2, make sure that you are able to break down the question into headings, subheadings, and to interpret the essay question correctly to show understanding of what is being asked. If you are able in your response to address all headings according to the question, you will be awarded a mark for analysis. For example, let us look at this essay and see if we can be able to analyze it enough to earn us the mark for analysis. The Labor Relations Act, LRA, 1995, Act 66 of 1995, makes provision for the rights of employees in the workplace. Businesses are expected to have a sound knowledge of this act for effective implementation. Many businesses implement legal advice to avoid penalties for non-compliance with the LRA. Write an essay on the Labor Relations Act in which you include the following aspects. Outline the rights of employees in terms of the Labor Relations Act. Explain the purpose of the Labor Relations Act. Discuss the impact of the Labor Relations Act on businesses. Advise businesses on penalties they may face for non-compliance with this act. How many headings would you come up with? Many of you would say 4 because you see 4. It doesn't work like that. The fact that you see 4 doesn't mean they are 4. Your body should have 5 headings in the case. First heading, rights of employees in terms of LRA, second heading, purpose of LRA, third heading, positive impact of LRA, fourth heading, negative impact of LRA, and lastly the fifth heading, penalties for non-compliance with LRA. If you manage to interpret the question to a point of earning between 16 and 32 marks, you will earn an additional mark for interpretation. So now you have 4 marks from thin air. How do people fail? To this day, it's a mystery. Scientists are still busy trying to figure it out. If you know anyone failing business studies, please buy them lunch. They deserve it. Number 3, you get marks for synthesis. Make sure you have relevant decisions or facts or responses made based on the questions. You will be awarded 2 marks for having relevant facts in your responses. Lastly, you get marks for being original and authentic. USA must have evidence of 1 or 2 examples not older than 2 years that are based on recent information, current trends and developments. For example, you can talk about the recent cholera outbreak in Hammanskjöld, Pretoria. It happened in 2023, so at this point in time it would be relevant. I hope these tips are helpful. Make sure you apply what's useful to you and discard what you think is a useless tip. Remember, don't be a follower, be a student. That's it from us here at the Distinction Bound Student. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. Also hit the notification bell for you to get notified every time we post new content to our channel. We are also giving away the Distinction Bound Student t-shirts to people who buy more than 10 books. At the moment, we have the following textbooks: Economics Grade 10, 11 and 12 plus Business Studies Grades 11 and 12. We are looking forward to adding more books to our catalog. Remember, our books come in two versions, complete and no answers versions. Complete versions have answers and no answers versions do not. Thank you so much for your support. See you in the next video. God bless.